Murphy in the morning.
Team for a four-pound bag of better-made Great Northern beans at Farmer's Market Warehouse Store, 8th and Jefferson. 722 with Murphy in the morning. We've been mentioning it on the show. David Towers is retiring from morning news person, moving to afternoon news person.
Isn't that wonderful?
And Dave...
Your request, you said.
That's right. I'd like to bring up, I've been here since last March. You've been my newsman ever since then. And as a kind word about, I'd like to say that in the entire time I've been here, I've never heard anybody say anything about you. And therefore, get ready, Tower, because this is your life, David Tower. That's all the applause we can afford for you. Since no one at the station seemed to know much about David Tower, we made several long-distance calls yesterday to talk to some of the people David knew as he was growing up in around the Texas area and here in Nashville, where he's been for the last 5 or 6 years. First, we talked to David, your family physician, Dr. Thumbs Foonman.
I remember him well.
We talked to him on the phone yesterday and asked him about David Tower.
Yes, David's been under my care for some time now. He's a sick man, you know. David's undergone 7 different sex change operations already. I just couldn't come up with anything he liked.
That was Dr. Thumbs Foonman, who we had talked to yesterday.
He promised me he'd never tell.
Well, he did. As we move right along with This Is Your Life, David Tower. Next, David, we place that long-distance call all the way back to Texas to talk to the lady who's responsible for this thing in the other room. That's right, old Mrs. Tower.
Don't tell me you found her at home.
Kindly old Mrs. Tower was at home, and we asked her about her son, David Tower.
David who? Oh, David Tower. Well, David was our son. I can still remember as if it were only yesterday, tossing little David into the river and pushing his little head under 3 times and letting him up twice. I was kind of surprised to hear that he was still around.
Your mother, of course, overjoyed to find you had a job here in Nashville as a star radio personality. And last but not least, we couldn't talk to your mother, kindly old Mrs. Tower, without talking to kindly old Mr. Tower, who had these words when he was asked about you, David.
David Tower, that's my son. Don't really remember much about him. He was our first kid, our only kid. Yeah, me and the little old lady weren't planning to have any children. We wouldn't have had David except the drug stores were closed on Sunday.
And that was your kindly old father, Mr. Tower.
Now the truth is told.
That's right. Now we have one final thing here. Now we were not able to determine the correct age on this, when it was done or anything like that. So we're just going to throw it at you and let's see if you can identify this piece of history that sometime from your past, let me ask you... Does the name Waterflow ring a bell? Yes, from Port Arthur, Texas, we found a recording studio that had this on stock.
In smoky places.
Would you like to identify this, Mr. Tower?
I don't think I remember that. Better yet, I think I'd like to forget.
See if we can jar your memory some. Tell the folks what this is.
This is a recording by... What's his name now?
David Tower is the name it says right on the label, a production of Tower Enterprises.
Right.
Recorded in Port Arthur, Texas.
1968.
Was this it? Right. Let the folks hear just a bit of it.
Oh, I cry.
Sounds just like you, Dave.
Your wedding day. Light my heart would break.
You never told us you're a recording star. That's because you weren't. We talked to the folks at the Port Arthur Recording Studio. They said they had 25,000 of their own backlog, still trying to get rid of them, still trying to move them into stores.
That's how the Frisbee came into being.
That's right.
They had to use them for something.
Murphy in the morning.